has never been easier. Awesome. And it's all because of Roto. That's R-O-D-O. Not only is Roto the best place to buy a new car, but you can also sell your used car or current vehicle lease to Roto for quick payment. Roto makes the process fast, fair, and transparent. So, sell your car on the Roto app or at roto.com. That's R-O-D-O. The fastest way to sell your used car for more cash than ever before. Living with dental issues is hard. No one knows this better than Joseph, who struggled with stinging teeth for years.
The inflammation, the bad breath, the tooth falling out, the pain.
These issues took their toll, so Joseph came to Clear Choice Dental Implant Center, where she discovered one procedure that can take the years of discomfort, pain, and compromise.
Once I got it done, I was like, why did you wait so long?
That's what dental implants did for Joseph. Find out what they can do for you by visiting clearchoice.com. Stater Brothers Markets would like to extend a warm welcome into the holiday season. And as we gather around the Thanksgiving table, let's share good food, good wine, and memories that'll last a lifetime. Stater Brothers Markets wishes you a happy Thanksgiving. From our family to yours. Big interview. You check your suit, your resume, your palms. But wait, did you check your breath? Get Smart Mouth, the only mouthwash that provides 24 hours of fresh breath with just 2 rinses a day. Find Smart Mouth in the mouthwash aisle at CVS. Or get 20% off at smartmouth.com/radio.
This is Liz.
Oh, hi, Mom.
She just stepped up to care for her mom. And she has questions. Lots of questions. Liz, meet CareWell. It's your shop for caregiving and medical supplies. Get brands like Depends, Ensure, and Tranquility delivered at prices you'll love from 24/7 care specialists trained to take your questions and super fast shipping. Caregiving isn't easy, but you don't have to do it alone. Visit carewell.com/radio for $10 off. That's carewell.com/radio. Terms apply.
When you're north of 65, in a lot of ways, life gets easier. Menus have whole sections dedicated to you, and people start offering you their seat. By enrolling in a Medicare health plan through Kaiser Permanente, that easy street keeps on going. Our high-quality health plans make it easy to access your health needs, often under one roof. So take advantage of all those senior benefits, so long as they benefit your health. Visit kp.org/Medicare to learn more. Kaiser Permanente. Thrive.
Friends, family, out-of-town guests, you've got a lot to celebrate this month, but that's also a lot of meals to prepare. Times like these, you want Fizzler. Tender hand-cut steak, plump juicy lobster, or that world-famous salad bar means there's something for everybody to celebrate. Whether you're looking for a quick solution on Thanksgiving night or a great place to gather the other 29 days of November, here we're open and best of all, we're delicious. For the nearest Fizzler restaurant, go to locations.fizzler.com.
Plenty of fat people get knee replacements. I mean, Steve, how big are you?
I've lost about 15 pounds. I need to lose about 10 more pounds. And the problem is, once your knee goes out, it's really hard to do any type of exercise. I'm just going by my metabolism, which is very slow.
Yeah, how big are you, Steve?
I'm 260.
260, and how tall are you?
I'm 5'8".
Oh, believe me, you need to lose a lot more than just 10 or 15 pounds.
Handle on the Law. Tomorrow morning at 8 on KFI.
More stimulating talk.
If you're injured and need a lawyer, go to handleonthelaw.com.
Welcome back, everybody. Bill Handel on a Friday with the morning crew, November 19th. Let's start with your chance for those dollars.
KFI has your chance to win $1,000.
Text the nationwide keyword deposit, D-E-P-O-S-I-T, to 200-200.
You'll get a confirmation text and info.
Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest.
That's deposit to 200-200.
God, I haven't heard that keyword before, deposit. We got it? I don't remember it. In any case, if you do win, you'll get a phone call from a phone number you don't recognize. You must pick it up. We do it every day, starting at 5:20 in the morning, wake-up call, right down to 7:20 p.m., 14 times a day. So if you don't win this hour, it's next hour. Let's return to Handle on the News with Jennifer and Wayne Ingy.
All right, the LAPD has identified a man who was killed by cops after he took a woman hostage in an apartment in downtown L.A. The guy is 45-year-old Rudy Anderson of L.A., and he was killed by cops after they went into an apartment where this guy was holding a woman hostage. Earlier in the day, they say that this guy, Rudy Anderson, had also tried to use his gun to carjack a driver and steal a bicycle in the downtown area, but they've got body cam footage of what went down. Neighbors obviously have video of what was going down in this, and that's the latest.
Yeah, I wonder what the thinking is with these guys. Surrounded by SWAT, still holding the woman hostage. Clearly, it's not going to end very well. Is it suicide by cop, or they're so into the zone of what they're doing, that part of it they don't even think about?
And we don't have information I don't know.
But you just wonder about these people. Well, two kids that were reported missing from back east have been found safe in Orange County in Dana Point, and a suspect is in custody. So you have the 3-year-old boy, Noah Claire. You have 16-year-old Amber Claire. And then 35-year-old Jacob Claire is the guy in custody. It looks like a case of abduction.
And that's usually the case.
Yeah.
In the vast majority of these Amber Alerts, it's the case. I don't know if the 16-year-old Amber Alert Claire actually called.
The mother of Noah called, and you had one issue was just that. I think Noah was in Tennessee, but Amber left Kentucky. So Tennessee put out an Amber Alert for Noah, but they couldn't do anything about Amber Claire because it wasn't their case. It made it a little harder, but the bottom line is they were found
here in Dana Point.
That guy's in jail.
Yeah, I mean, across the country.
Mm-hmm.
All right, remember yesterday, if you were driving into work, about this time yesterday morning, you saw the Amber Alert signs up about the Chrysler minivan where they had an abduction, all of that. It was a reported abduction of a 15-year-old girl from Santa Rosa in Northern California from a gas station parking lot where they said, oh, she was pulled into this van and against her will and all this. Well, turns out they've now talked to her. She's fine. And this all was a, as they put it, poorly planned, decided prank. So apparently this was her boyfriend who grabbed her and put her in this van. And it was all part of a surprise trip to L.A. for her birthday.
Oh, so it's not one of those YouTube challenges.
No.
Brilliant. Brilliant. By the way, talking about driving this morning, did you notice how much fog there was?
Oh, the fog.
It was scary. It really was. Oh, did anybody last night watch the lunar eclipse?
No, because it happened too late. Did you?
Yeah, I did.
No, I was...
I did. I set the alarm.
Wow.
Was it worth it?
No.
Oh.
Not even close.
Was it foggy? Could you see it?
Yeah. You know, it was pretty clear.
Yeah.
Yeah, the fog came in this morning. It looked like a waning moon is what it was. That's it. No, thank you. And the only thing that made it neat was last time it happened was 500 and something years ago. And the next one is going to be 2,400, 2,400 and something. Whoopee. Oh, boy, a woman is in big trouble. Over the course of 120 visits to a Target store in San Francisco, she stole over $40,000 worth of stuff. She would go to the self-checkout kiosk, scan it, and then pay, like, give them a dollar, or in some cases, a penny, and leave with all the stuff. And finally, Target, called the cops and said, would you please do something about this woman? So they have her now on a bunch of misdemeanor counts, 120 misdemeanor counts of petty theft, 8 felony counts of grand theft.
Yeah, I wonder why it was
brazen.
Yeah, you wonder why it was 40
going back.
But think about this: it's $40,000 later, 120 incidents later, is when they get her.
Mm-hmm.
You think they would have gotten her a little bit sooner than that?
You know, with this whole with the change in the law in California, and a lot of this is petty theft. Cops, you call up the cops and go, hey, we have somebody here,
and they don't bother
under $1,000, What are they going to do? They're not going to gear up a whole machinery to come there and stake it out and wait for it to come again.
Right.
It just became so much, and I think because they were able to show that on 8 of these incidents, she took enough for it to be a felony. And that's when they finally decided to do something.
And haven't you guys noticed, too, how... Does it feel so odd to you? Because it does to me. When I go to a place like Target and I walk out with, I don't know, detergent and, scent beads or whatever... I'm walking out the door with no bag. I'm just holding these random items in my hand. It feels weird. It's just like, I feel like I need to show somebody my receipt.
You're so cheap, you won't spend 10 cents for a bag.
Well, but only a few things. Why do I need a bag?
To not feel the way you feel?
Yeah.
Okay, well, this morning, 120 counts.
Misdemeanor count.
120
misdemeanor. Right. And the judge gets pissed off enough
serves consecutively.
Don't add up.
There's 120 years right there.
What the grand gesture?
Yeah. I wouldn't, you know what, no offense to her, but I wouldn't mind seeing something like that happen.
Let's take a break. We'll come back, and we have yet to do more handle on the news. Jennifer, what's up?
All right, let's talk more about those kids from Tennessee. The Orange County Sheriff says two kids who were kidnapped in Tennessee will be able to go home to their families because a woman stepped up. Sheriff Don Barnes says Julia Bonin called police when she saw Jacob Clare with a 3-year-old son and 16-year-old niece in Dana Point.
But more importantly, what she did not do is place yourself in harm while doing it. Make the contact, describe the event, let us intercede appropriately and investigate whatever might be being reported.
Barnes said Claire was arrested yesterday on a kidnapping warrant. The three had disappeared earlier this week. Claire's car had turned up in San Clemente earlier in the week. News is brought to you by veteran-owned Semper Solaris. The mother of a man shot and killed in San Bernardino says she believes there are people who saw what happened but aren't talking to cops about it. Andre Marin was killed outside a liquor store 9 days ago. His mother, Kimberly McGowan, says police haven't given her much information because they're still investigating. She says she thinks many people know the shooter but are keeping a code of silence. McGowan says that's stopping her son from getting justice. Newport Beach has fired up its Emergency Operations Center to simulate a fire that burned hundreds of homes in the area in 1993.
We didn't have incident management teams.
Newport Beach Fire Marshal Kevin Bass says back then the response started with the local agency.
Feeling overwhelmed, calling for help, and then it would be a disorganized effort to get the resources to that agency.
Dozens of first responders from state, county, and surrounding cities yesterday practiced responses for evacuations and ground and air support.
It's amazing how fast the fire can move and how fast an aircraft can move.
The fire in 93 swallowed 16,000 acres, at times moving an estimated 100 acres per minute at the Emergency Operations Center in Newport Beach. Corbin Carson, KFI News.
Toyota is recalling more than 200,000 Camry sedans for possible brake problems. The company says the recall covers certain 2018 and 2019 model Camrys because they can suddenly lose the power assist in the brake system. Owners will be notified about places they can go to fix the problem by January. Emissions testing will expand in California thanks to a new facility in Riverside.
The $419 million research center will allow for more checks on heavy-duty vehicles such as trucks, buses, and bulldozers in addition to cars. It replaces a nearly 50-year-old lab in nearby El Monte that state officials credit with helping to detect the VW diesel emissions cheating scandal. The state has long been viewed as a clean air regulations leader. Deborah Marsh, KFI News.
A judge in New York has tossed out the convictions of two men who spent decades in prison for the murder of civil rights leader Malcolm X in 1965.
There can be no question that this is a case that cries out for fundamental justice.
The Manhattan DA's office and the men's lawyer said a new investigation found evidence that Muhammad Aziz and Khalil Islam were not involved with the killing and that cops and the FBI withheld some of what they knew. Islam died in 2009. Manhattan District Attorney Cy Vance apologized in court for what he called serious and unacceptable violations of the law. And two turkeys in Indiana will live to see another Thanksgiving thanks to a pardon by President Biden. The turkeys named Peanut Butter and Jelly are set to get the presidential pardon at the White House today. Presidential turkey pardons have been part of the White House tradition for more than 150 years. We've got problems on the Vincent Thomas Bridge.
Oh boy, we sure do. It's becoming way too popular, but heads up now, this could make you late. Eastbound, Vincent Thomas Bridge, San Diego to Long Beach, that direction, shut down for a lot of pedestrians on the bridge. We'll follow up and make and find out what's going on. The westbound is open for now, but again, just be aware of this. BCA, Canahan Street, that'll get you where you need to go. A little bit of good news for the East LA interchange. They're leaving there. It's L5 around Denton, Indiana. Had a problem in lanes. That's going away right now. A big problem continues in Orange County. West 22, west of the I-5 City Drive. Most of the freeway shut down. Back up through the 5. If you can get on the West 22 at Harbor Boulevard, you will be past all these problems and on your way. And real quick, downtown Los Angeles, North 110 and 5th, yet another small fire off the freeway. Fire department's on the way. Be careful. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Jeff Ball.
The Ducks win streak came to an end last night with a 2-1 loss to the Carolina Hurricanes. Good news, though, the Angel Shohei Ohtani has been named unanimously the American League MVP. He logged 46 home runs, 100 RBI, and as a pitcher, an ERA of 3.18, Ohtani also had the most triples of any player in the league. The National League MVP is Bryce Harper of the Phillies. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports. Tomorrow, there is a free seminar in Montclair at the Cunning Dental Clinic, where you'll meet patients and talk to the doctors and learn all about their permanent teeth in a day procedure done while you are sleeping. And this is about taking that mouth of yours, which is so god-awful, loose, missing, decayed teeth, and then waking up out of a dentist chair and literally having a brilliant new permanent smile. I mean, that's it. You're done for the rest of your life. Never another dental procedure, and you probably never look this good. The food you used to eat, smile when you take a photo. That is what Dr. Cunning's procedure, new permanent teeth in a day procedure, is all about. Call to reserve your seat, limited seating, obviously. You can also get a free exam anytime. Just give them a call. And right now until November 30th, $1,500 off your procedure. If you have dental insurance, got to use it by the end of the year. Call 888-640-SMILE, 888-640-SMILE, 888-640-SMILE.
SoCal weather from KFI. We've got a foggy start to the morning and cloudy conditions as well. Later in the day, just partly cloudy. That's what highs will reach upper 60s to right at 70 for Metro LA and OC. Mid to upper 70s for the valleys in the IE. More of the same tomorrow. A little warmer and windy for Sunday. We lead local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Jennifer Jones Lee.
It's Huntington Beach and Riverside Harley's Triple Zero event. Zero cash down, zero interest, and zero payments until 2022 on any new Harley this week only. Huntington Beach and Riverside Harley has the largest Harley inventory in California with hundreds of bikes in stock. Huntington Beach and Riverside Harley has secured financing terms that can save you thousands on interest. No cash down, no payments, no interest until 2022. Annual percentage rates such as 1.99% and no payments until March on any new Harley. Huntington Beach and Riverside Harley's Triple Zero event. Now through Sunday.
Hey, it's Jerry. Medicare annual enrollment is here, and it's time to keep your Medicare moving forward with SCAN Health Plan. SCAN is a comprehensive Medicare Advantage plan with new cost savings benefits. Plans for 2022 may include $125 monthly get-back, lower out-of-pocket costs, more included dental coverage, and more. To learn more, call SCAN Health Plan at 1-855-479-7226, TPY 711, or ask your local agent about SCAN. Call SCAN to see if you qualify. SCAN Health Plan is an HMO plan with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in SCAN Health Plan depends on contract renewal.
Hi, Tim Connell here of Connell Chevrolet, Costa Mesa. Right now, get $500 Chevy Cyber Cash on select new Chevys during our Black Friday sales event at ConnellChevrolet.net. Find new roads at Connell Chevrolet, the Orange County original since 1964.
Hi, we're Hoke. Meet Dr. Daryl Perlstein. He's a thoracic surgeon at the Hoke Family Cancer Institute who loves the outdoors and hiking. He's also a leader in robotic-assisted surgery who trains other surgeons nationwide. Dr. Perlstein would love to get to know you and is ready to make a positive difference in your family's life. Get to know Hoke. Visit HokeHealth.org and find your physician today.
Are you paying too much for auto insurance? Visit AAA.com/insurance for a free quote and find out how much you could save. Find competitive rates on auto insurance through the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
Visit MechanicCars.com before you purchase your new automobile this holiday season.
For official rules and more information about contacts on this station, go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
KFI, Smart and Final, and Barilla are teaming up for this year's Pastathon.
Donating right now at any Smart and Final location.
Details at Pastathon.com. KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Friday morning, November 19th. Let's go ahead and continue on with more Handle on the News. Jennifer Jones Lee, Wayne Resnick, and me.
All right, this is the craziest story. So a woman is driving her Nissan, and the truck in front of her slows down. She then slows down. But the semi-truck behind her does not slow down. Ends up smashing into her from behind, basically pulls her Nissan in half. And then the truck lands on top of the Nissan. All of a sudden now, people say there's no way. They look at this crash and they're thinking, oh my God, there's no way anybody survived that. The woman was able to not only survive, but came away with minor injuries by crawling out the window.
I know.
total miracle. The cops, everybody didn't understand. I mean, she's lucky she is. You know, she, I mean, she got out, you know? She was, I mean, smashed in the middle.
I saw the pictures of this. There's no way. There's no way you think anybody could survive this. And there she was.
Oh, a story we were talking a little bit about this earlier.
Well, holiday travel over Thanksgiving is expected to be near pre-pandemic levels, meaning the airports are going to be terrible, the freeways are going to be terrible. TSA claims that they have ramped up and that they're ready, but does anybody feel highly confident about that claim?
Not a chance.
The other thing is they want you to know if you're flying, please pay attention to the TSA people because they're going to be telling you, they're going to be trying to help you, like, point you towards a shorter line or guide you around someone who's taking too long. And so please, even though it sounds like you're just yelling at everybody, that you should pay attention.
Hey, here's a question.
They're so rude when they give you the, when they tell you about what you need to take out or now. Now you've got this issue. I know that at American here, you go into the thing and they have two scanners for the baggage. One of them, you have to take your electronics out. The other one, you cannot take your electronics out. So they're screaming at people, take out your things. Don't take out your things. You take out your things. Don't take out your things.
And it's not pre-flight.
Pre-check.
Right?
Pre-check. No, it's not pre-check. Okay. No, it's regular old, you know, cattle.
Yeah,
cattle
I have a question. Let's give them the benefit of the doubt. They are ready.
Yes.
When you have this number of people,
yeah, you can't.
I mean, you're overwhelmed. It doesn't matter how ready you are. You know, for the Astro World concert, right? Let's say they had double the security. It's 50,000 people that are storming the stage. What do you do with that?
I would just say, I just got up from the airport, let's see, Friday, Wednesday night. More people than I've ever seen at Ontario Airport. We are back to pre-pandemic levels even now, and we're not even in Thanksgiving week yet. But the one thing that I've noticed that I've flown out of Ontario, at least twice or three times, I guess, over the past month or two. And the pre-check line goes like a flash. If you have the opportunity to go get pre-check, it's $85 for 5 years.
And
it's totally worth it because the regular line, even at Dinky Little Ontario, you're ridiculous.
Oh, yeah.
And really, can you get it?
That's what I don't know. So it might be too late for Thanksgiving, but if you're traveling over Christmas, I would get it. It's so worth it.
I'm sure you're staying in the big week. And also, we get to go to the LAX too. No, there's one with regional airport in Miami. But after that, it's the worst airport on the planet. It's crazy.
Well, the company's closed, that's a supply chain in many, that's basically everything, the company's products will be available this holiday season. He says that the availability isn't the only concern because he has the prices. Jim Ryan yesterday was talking with me, and I think the average price, I think he said, the holiday was 14 or 15%. So this is, you know, this is significant compared to last year.
Sure.
And it's everything from the price of turkey, which I think was up over 20%, but also we've all talked on this show about the price of clams. So you go to get your, you know, cranberry sauce or whatever, that price is gone because cranberry, first of all, they're having trouble with that supply. The clam itself costs more because of the supply chain issues. I mean, it's just the sickle down.
He said, no, we're in really good shape. And the cranberry people are bogged down with their supply issues.
Stop being a turkey, please.
I hope I'm underestimating them, which isn't really happening.
Former NFL football player who has been arrested
It was on social media, someone that happened to be out there.
who is watching this go down, and I do think that, and this is a very large number.